वर्ड कैन डिस्क्राइब एन ऑब्जेक्ट इन फोर वेज. दिस इज पतंजलि एनालिसिस. पतंजलि इज दि महाभाष्यकार. सो दि वर्ड इज एनालाइज्ड इन दट शास्त्र. इट इज कॉल्ड पदशास्त्र. पद मीन्स वर्ड. सो वी हैव टू शास्त्रास इन संस्कृत. वेरी एनालिटिकल शास्त्रास. वन इज पदशास्त्र विच इज व्याकरण विच एनालाइजेस all about the word, pada shastra. And we have vakya shastra, which is called mimamsa. So how a vakya has to be analyzed. Yesterday I was telling you about you sadvidha tatparya lingas etc. So there is all vakya shastra, mimamsa. So pada shastra, pada shastra means vyakarana. And Patanjali Maharshi in Mahabhashyam, he describes how the pada works, how it functions. So he says a pada addresses the issue on hand in four ways. One, it teaches you or it reveals to you jati. Jati it reveals. Example, gauh. Gauh means a cow. You see how similar they are, how close they are? Gauh and cow. So only just ga became ka, otherwise that au also is maintained. Very interesting. So anyway, gauhu. So a cow is there. So when you say a cow, that word represents a jati. Cow does not mean that one particular cow. Though it is singular, it can represent any cow and every cow in the universe. So we use ekavachanam because there is a rule. Patanjali again, Vyakarana Shastra, jatau ekavachanam. Whenever you have to refer to the jati, when you have to reveal to the jati, reveal the jati, you use ekavachanam. Manushyaha. Manushyaha means not the one individual who is known to me. That is not the meaning of manushyaha. Manushyaha can refer to every human being. The word can refer to every human being. So that means it represents jati, not a vyakti. Vyakti means individual. This manushyaha means it becomes individual because of this. Otherwise, if you simply say manushyaha, it represents jati. So that is how words function. Kriya. Second is jati, second is kriya. Pachakaha. Pachati iti pachakaha. A cook. So a kriya, noun we are talking about as examples, you can give verbs also. So kriya means all the verbs are included in it, action. And the nouns derived from the verbs also included. So pachakaha is it is a word which reveals a person by virtue of his profession, the action that he performs. On that basis, it reveals. So jati, kriya. Third is guna. Guna is an attribute. So neelaha, shuklaha, ketaha, raktaha. So all such things are gunas. Sadhuhu, kroraha, akroraha. All these are gunas. So, based on a quality, you use a word. So, word describes the quality. Guna. Jati, guna, kriya. Over. The entire universe is now covered. Only one aspect is left. That is the interrelationships. So, that is sambandha. So, this book is mine. That sambandha. Mama, shashti. So, the sambandha has to be specified. So there also the word helps in revealing the sambandha. Only four: jati, guna, kriya, sambandha. Now Brahma doesn't come under the category of jati because jati implies many individuals. A species implies a number of samples in the species, number of individuals. So if there are two or more or Brahmas, 3, 4, 5, 10 Brahmas are there, then the word Brahma, the word can reveal it as a jati. So therefore, jati is not there for Brahma. Then guna is not there for Brahma. It is nirgunam Brahma. Kriya is not there. So nishkriyam Brahma it is. And sambandha it is not there because when you advitiyam brahma we say, there is no second, neha nanastikinchana. Nana is not there. Plurality is false. So where is the question of sambandha when it is non-dual? There cannot be any sambandha. But at the same time you may say, there can be a sambandha with the mithya. So we say asangohyayam purushaha. Even that kind of a sambandha is not acceptable. Therefore sambandha is not there. So the world can reveal an object based on its ability to reveal these four, jati guna kriya sambandha. And with reference to Atma or Brahma, all these four ways the word cannot approach it. Therefore, word remains at a distance. So, viduraya, namo giram, viduraya, words remain at a distance. So, that means, mukhya vritti, that abhidha vritti we call it, the primary meaning of the word, cannot reveal Brahma. Only the lakshana, by lakshana you can reveal Brahma. So you catch hold of something and with that something you make progress while leaving that something. So that is what is called a lakshana. So what we say is we start with the pot. What is this pot? Pot is nothing but clay. Clay is nothing but the sat from which it has come. Therefore, that sat is Parambrahma. Like that, starting from the word pot, we go to Parambrahma. We work backwards and reach the Parambrahma. So, Parambrahma is what? Jagat Karanam. So, start with Jagat. Jagat is known. It can be revealed by words or by senses. So, start with the Jagat and work upwards. Upwards in the sense, in the cognition. So, go to the Jagat Karanam. There must be a Karanam for the Jagat. And that Karanam, even the Karanam is not Brahma. The essential Swarupa of the Karanam, the Karanatvam has to be dropped again. That is Brahma. So, Sarva Nishedhavati. So, is it a very interesting thing is, Brahma cannot be revealed by words directly, and there is no need to reveal the Brahma by words directly or indirectly. There is no need. Because Brahma is your own Swarupa. So, to realize your own Swarupa, what all you have to do is remove the estrangement from the Swarupa, that is enough. So, you have separated yourself from the Swarupa by ignorance. So, the ignorance becomes a wall between you and the Swarupam. So, your effort is not to catch hold of the Swarupam. That effort is not required. Because Swarupa, you need not catch hold of it, it is you. Only thing you have to do is, you have to drop the ignorance, you have to negate the ignorance. So, for Swarupa Nirupanam, to reveal the Swarupa, there is no need for words. So, words only help to eliminate, to negate, to nullify what is not this Swarupa. So, this is how it is revealed by the Shastram. That's why Neti Neti Tyadeshaha. The entire Upadesha is in the form of negation. It is negation from A to Z, it is negation. Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, Brahma, there also it is negation. Satyam, in this world, every object that is known to us is immortal. So, is mortal. So, only mortality or Vinasha is known to us. Avinashi is not known to us. So, directly this is an Avinashi object. Like that, it is not known. Only Avinashi road is known to us. An Avinashi object is not known to us. So, that's why you cannot visualize Avinashi object like any other object. So what all you can do is the limitations of Vinasha of time are negated. And by the time you negate it, whatever remains is your Swarupa. So like that every word is a negation. Jnanam, Jadatvam is negated. Parokshatvam is negated. So insentient thing is negated. So limitations of Tesha Kala Vastu are negated by the word Anantam. So like that it is negation from A to Z. Every word is a negation. So Shuddham. Shuddham is also a negation. A Sangha is negated. So everywhere it is negation. So Idamittham. So this is Brahma. Like that words cannot reveal. So Namo Giram Viduraya Manasaha. Even the mind is the same. Chetasamuti. So, Chetasamis Chitta Vritti Naam. Generally, mind is a general name అండ్ చిత్తవృత్తి ఆర్ చేత ఈజ్ అన్ ఇండివిజువల్ థింగ్. సో మైండ్ యాజ్ ఎ కలెక్టివ్ మైండ్ యాజ్ ఎ కలెక్టివ్ ఇంద్రియం అంతరింద్రియం ద ఇన్నర్ ఎ సెన్స్ ఆర్గన్. సో దట్ మైండ్ యాజ్ ఎ కలెక్టివ్ థింగ్ ఇట్ ఈస్. సో దట్ కెనాట్ రివీల్ బ్రహ్మ. నాట్ ఈవెన్ ఎన్ ఇండివిజువల్ వృత్తి కెనాట్ రివీల్ బ్రహ్మ. సో నమో గిరాం మనసః చేతసామపి విదూరాయ. బికాస్ ఏ వృత్తి కెనాట్ ఆబ్జెక్టిఫై బ్రహ్మ. దెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ అఖండాకార వృత్తి బై విచ్ బ్రహ్మజ్ఞానం టేక్స్ ప్లేస్? సో వీ టాక్ ఆఫ్ దాట్. సో హౌ ఇట్ ఈస్ డన్? ఈజ్ ఇట్ నాట్ ఎ కాంట్రడిక్షన్? ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ఎ కాంట్రడిక్షన్. దెన్ వీ సే మైండ్ కెనాట్ ఆబ్జెక్టిఫై బ్రహ్మ అండ్ బ్రహ్మ ఈజ్ నాట్ అవైలబుల్ ఫర్ ది మైండ్. వీ మీన్ ఎ మైండ్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఇంప్యూర్, బ్రహ్మ ఈజ్ నాట్ అవైలబుల్. దట్ ఈస్ వన్ మీనింగ్. మనసైవాను ద్రష్టవ్యం అనదర్ మీనింగ్ ఈస్ దే. సో టూ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ శృతీస్ ఆర్ దేర్. హౌ? సో యతో వాచో నివర్తంతే అప్రాప్య మనసా సహ. సో వర్డ్స్ కెనాట్ రివీల్, వర్డ్స్ ఫెయిల్ టు రీచ్. సో ఇట్స్ మీనింగ్ ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ, డైరెక్ట్లీ దే కెనాట్ రీచ్ ఇట్ అర్థ. దెన్ ఇండైరెక్ట్లీ బై వర్స్ ఆఫ్ నిగేషన్ దే గో ఆన్ నిగేటింగ్, అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ నిగేషన్ ఈజ్ ఓవర్ వాట్ ఎవర్ రిమైన్స్ ఈజ్ యువర్ స్వరూప. So there also words cannot reach it. They help in negating the non-entity or in negating the tattvam thing which is not the reality. So non-reality is negated. Then coming to the mind, I tell you, every chitta vritti is a khandita chitta vritti. Khandita. How? You see, I see a path. Immediately ghatajnanam takes place. How the ghatajnanam takes place? The fact that the pot is known by you implies that you as the knower is different. The ghata as the known is different. And the process of knowing is different. So this is what is called triputi. In fact, the entire jagat consists of this bhedam alone. గ్రాహ్య గ్రాహక భేద ఎలోన్, వాట్ ఎల్స్ భేదం ఇట్ ఈస్. సో ఐఎమ్ ది గ్రాహక అండ్ ది ఎంటైర్ థింగ్ ఈస్ గ్రాహ్య. సో ఇన్ ఎవ్రీ పీస్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ దట్ యు గెట్ ఫ్రమ్ మార్నింగ్ వెన్ యూ వేకప్ టిల్ యూ గో బ్యాక్ ఇన్ టు ది స్లీప్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఇన్ డ్రీమ్ స్టేట్, ఎవ్రీ పీస్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ ఇన్వేరియబ్లీ ప్రాజెక్ట్స్ ఎ డ్యూయాలిటీ, ఎ ప్లూరాలిటీ. ఎవ్రీ పీస్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్, ఎనీ పీస్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్. సో దెర్ ఈజ్ నో సింగిల్ నాలెడ్జ్ which does not project a plurality. So that is the reason why we say mind cannot objectify Brahma, because Brahma is advitiyam. So like even every other object is known, in that way Brahma cannot be known, because Brahma is advitiyam. Every other object is known including duality, plurality. No object is known without plurality. So Brahma cannot be known while maintaining plurality. How you can know Brahma? Therefore, khandita jnanam, which is the usual practice of the mind, that khandita jnanam cannot reveal Brahma. Then how Brahma can be revealed by a vritti? This is called akhandakara vritti. Means a vritti in which this khanda, this division of grahya and grahaka is not there. That kind of a vritti it is. So what happens is, aham brahmasmi, when you know, this aham resolves in Brahma. Aham will not remain. Aham remains, and then if it is understood as Brahma while retaining the aham, then it is a khandita jnanam only. So aham, the aham is resolved in Brahma. So the I sense is gone in this jnanam. Suppose ghata jnanam is there. The moment you know ghata, I is projected along with it. I am the knower of ghata. Without I projection, there is no ghata jnanam. But in the Brahma jnanam, the jnanam is in such a way that I consciousness is resolved in that attributeless consciousness. So that's why it is called akhandakara vritti. Having given that kind of an akhanda jnanam, that vritti also resolves into that Brahma, because vritti cannot exist. Like even a wave cannot exist outside the ocean, vritti does not exist outside Brahma. Therefore, vritti resolves in Brahma. even if the vritti is retained or it comes back, it is negated. Badhita anuvritti is there. Badhita anuvritti. So, like even you see at the sky, blue sky, and yet know that it is not blue. Similarly, even if the vritti comes out, so we know that it doesn't exist outside the consciousness. So its mithyatvam is known to you. So this is what is called akhandakara vritti. That way only Brahma can be known, not as an object. So this is the total analysis of this knowing of Brahman and all that. You see how small shlokam it is, but it requires this kind of an understanding. Namo giram viduraya manasas chetasamapi. We will take up the next shlokam. Satvena pratilabhyaya naishkarmyena vipaschita namah kaivalyanathaya nirvana sukha samvide. You see, the moment we said that Parameshwara is not objectified by the words, by the chitta vrittis, or even buddhi or mind stuff, so then a concept may take place in the mind that Ishvara cannot be understood, he cannot be known. So he remains unknown forever. No, not like that. Though Ishvara is Chetasam Manasaha Giram Viduraya, is very, very far for all these things, yet Pratilabhyaya, he can be attained, he can be gained. Parameshwara can be gained. Gained by whom? Vipaschita. Vipaschita means by a jnani. Vipaschita means a jnani. Very interesting word. So that chit is there, you know. Chit is there. Pashyati is there. Pash is the remnant of the pashyati. Vi is vishesha. So all put together becomes a jnani. Vipaschita. So visheshena pasyati atmanam chaitanya rupena iti vipaschita tena vipaschita. So a jnani chattha, brahma jnani, jivan muktaha, a mahatma, a jnani. So for him, by him, pratilabhyaya, Ishvara can be readily gained. How gained? Labhyaya, it could have said. So, the Maharshi could say labhyaya. Why he should say pratilabhyaya? You see, he is not labhya like a pot, like you gained a pot. So now a pot is labhya, ghato labhya. Like that Ishvara cannot be available. Pratilabhyaya, pratyatvena labhyaya, atmarupena labhyaya ityartha. Prati is pratyak. Pratyak means what? Atma, pratyakatma. So atma-rupa, the prati is, it represents pratyaka. Pratilabhyaya means pratyaktvena, pratyagatma-rupena labhyaya. He is available as the Shuddha Chaitanyam that is obtaining in this body, mind, sense complex. So that is the essential content of every vritti of I. Every time you say I, in that I, there are two parts. One part is a changing part. That is called idam amshaha. Another part is an invariable part. That is called anidam amshaha. For example, you say, morning when I meet you, you said, how are you? Oh, I am okay. Afternoon I met, then I said, how are you? I am not okay. So, in the morning aham sukhi, by afternoon aham dukhi. Therefore, there is a change, variable portion is there. And an invariable portion is there. So that variable portion of aham is mithya. And any variable thing is mithya only. That is the definition of mithya. Now it is there, now it is not there. That is mithya. So you have seen snake there now, then in another 2 minutes if you see it is a rope, it is not snake. So what happened to the snake? It is gone. That is how it is mithya. Therefore aham sukhi. In 5 minutes aham dukhi. That means what? Aham is the real thing. And the sukhi and dukhi is the mithya. So like that, in that aham, there is an invariable amsha and a variable amsha, that idam amsha and anidam amsha. Anidam amsha is the chaitanyam. దట్ ఈస్ ది ప్రత్యక్. సో ఇన్ దట్ రూపం, ఇన్ దట్ ఫామ్, ఈశ్వర కెన్ బి గెయిన్డ్ బై ఎ జ్ఞాని విపశ్చిత ప్రతిలభ్యాయ. నౌ యు సే ఇట్ కెన్, బ్రహ్మ కెనాట్ బి గెయిన్డ్ బై మైండ్, సో నౌ హౌ టు గెయిన్ ఇట్? సత్వేన, మైండ్ ఎలోన్. సో బట్ ది నాట్ ది మైండ్ విచ్ ఈజ్ కంటామినేటెడ్ బై రజస్ అండ్ తమస్. సో నౌ వీఆర్ కమింగ్ టు గుణ నిరూపణం. సో ఇన్ గీతా యు మస్ట్ హావ్ స్టడీడ్ గుణత్రయ విభాగ యోగ. సో ద గుణాస్ ఆర్ కమింగ్ ఇన్ ది నెక్స్ట్ శ్లోకం ఆల్సో సమ్ గుణాస్ డిస్క్రిప్షన్ ఇస్ దేర్. సో ది మైండ్ ఈజ్ ఎ సీట్ ఆఫ్ త్రీ గుణాస్ ఇన్ ది సెన్స్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ ప్రొడక్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది ప్రకృతి. ప్రకృతి ఈజ్ త్రిగుణాత్మిక. ప్రకృతి ఈజ్ సత్వరజస్తమో గుణాత్మిక. బిఫోర్ ది ప్రోడక్ట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో సత్వరజస్తమో గుణాత్మిక. ఇట్ బికమ్స్, ఇట్ ఈస్ బౌండ్ టు బి. దెన్ దేర్ ఆర్ త్రీ గుణాస్, సత్వ రజస్ అండ్ తమస్. సో హౌ యు సీ, ఇట్స్ నాట్ దట్ దేర్ ఆర్ ఎ ఫ్యూ పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ఓన్లీ సత్వ నమో రజస్ నో తమస్. ఇట్స్ నాట్ లైక్ దట్. ఎవ్రీ హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్ హ్యాస్ గాట్ ఎ మైండ్ విచ్ ఈజ్ ఎ మిక్స్చర్ ఆఫ్ సత్వ రజస్ అండ్ తమస్. ఇట్స్ ఓన్లీ ది పర్సంటేజెస్ వేరీ. సో హౌ మచ్ సత్వ, హౌ మచ్ రజస్ అండ్ హౌ మచ్ తమస్. ఎవరీ హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్ ఇన్ వన్స్ ఓన్ లైఫ్ టైమ్ దేర్ ఆర్ ఫేజెస్ వెన్ రజస్ ఈజ్ మోర్, తమస్ ఈజ్ మోర్ అండ్ సత్వ ఈజ్ లెస్, ఆల్ దట్. సపోజ్ ఎ చైల్డ్ ఈజ్ బోర్న్, ఈ డజంట్ ఈవెన్ ఓపెన్ ది ఐస్, ఆల్వేజ్ స్లీప్స్. చిల్డ్రన్ స్లీప్, మంత్స్ ఓల్డ్ బేబీ స్లీప్స్ 20 hours ఏ డే. సో ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ దే సే చిల్డ్రన్ గ్రో ఇన్ స్లీప్ ఓన్లీ. సో దే గో ఆన్ స్లీపింగ్ అండ్ స్లీపింగ్ అండ్ స్లీపింగ్ ఫర్ ది ఫస్ట్ 4-5 months ఆఫ్ ది లైఫ్ ది చైల్డ్ విల్ బి మోస్ట్లీ స్లీపింగ్. సో ఇట్ ఇస్ స్లెప్ట్ ఇన్ ది వూమ్ ఆఫ్ ది మదర్ అండ్ నౌ ఇట్ కంటిన్యూస్ ద సేమ్ హ్యాబిట్. దట్స్ వై ఇన్ దట్ ఫస్ట్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది లైఫ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ మోస్ట్లీ తమోగుణ ప్రధాన. దెన్ ది చైల్డ్ బికమ్స్ యాక్టివ్. నౌ తమోగుణ ఈజ్ రెలిగేటెడ్ ఇన్ టు ది బ్యాక్గ్రౌండ్ అండ్ యాక్టివిటీ కమ్స్ ఫార్వర్డ్. సో చైల్డ్ ప్లేస్ సో మచ్. ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ వెన్ ఇట్ ఇస్ సో హాట్ అవుట్ సైడ్ ది చిల్డ్రన్ విల్ ప్లే క్రికెట్. 42 degrees centigrade దే విల్ బి ప్లేయింగ్ క్రికెట్. ఇట్ ఈస్ మియర్ మ్యాడ్నెస్. సో ఇట్ అపియర్స్ ఫర్ అస్ బికాస్ వీ కాంట్ డేర్ టు గో ఇన్ టు ది ఓపెన్ స్ట్రీట్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ది బ్లేజింగ్ సన్. యూ కెనాట్ ఇమాజిన్ గోయింగ్ అవుట్ ఇన్ టు ది స్ట్రీట్ బట్ దెన్ యూ సీ పీపుల్ విల్ బి ప్లేయింగ్ క్రికెట్. సో దట్ రజోగుణం ఇట్ ఈస్. సో దట్ రజోగుణం ఈజ్ ఓవర్ దెన్ యూ బికమ్ ఏ మిడిల్ ఏజ్డ్ పర్సన్ అండ్ ఇఫ్ ఈజ్ ఏ కాంటెంపులేటివ్ మైండ్ ఈజ్ దేర్, అస్యూమింగ్ దట్ హీస్ ఏ కాంటెంపులేటివ్ మైండ్, అదర్వైజ్ హీ విల్ గో బ్యాక్ ఇన్ టు తమో గుణం. సో రజస్ ఈస్ గాన్ అగైన్ హీ గోస్ బ్యాక్ ఇన్ టు తమో గుణం. లై డౌన్, రీడ్ హిందూ పేపర్. ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ ది వన్ యాంటీ హిందూ పేపర్ కాల్డ్ ది హిందూ. సో యూ రీడ్ ఇట్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ఎండ్ టు దట్ ఎండ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ వెరీ బిగ్ పేపర్ ఇట్ ఈస్. ఫ్రమ్ 25 pages ఆర్ 30 pages విల్ బీ దేర్. సో రీడ్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ది హిందూ ఎడ్జెక్టివ్ ప్రింటెడ్ బై కస్తూరి ఎక్సెట్రా సంథింగ్ విల్ బి దేర్. సో దేర్ యూ స్టాప్ ఇట్. ఓపెన్ పేజ్ సమ్ అట్టర్లీ యూస్లెస్ ఇర్రెలవెంట్ మెటీరియల్ విల్ బి ప్రింటెడ్ అండ్ యూ కెన్ రీడ్ ఇట్. సో లైక్ దట్ యూ గోయిన్ టు తమో గుణం. సో బ్యాక్ టు ది తమస్, దేర్ ఇస్ నో సత్వ ఎట్ ఆల్. సో this is how it happens for a government servant, especially that is how it happens. So it should not happen like that. As the age increases, so this rajoguna will go back. That the young age is mostly rajoguna, it goes back and sattva gunam comes forward. Then that is contemplative life. So then only you read Gita etc. So that sattva gunam is shining, blossoming. So this is sattvaguna. Sattvaguna is what? It is an equilibrium of rajas and tamas. It is not a mixture or any such thing. Sattvaguna means you sit and listen to the lecture class. So from morning to evening you are sitting only. So it appears to be tamas, not tamas. Suppose if you go to village, there are some lazy people. What they do from morning to evening, they will be sitting there. Sometime on this, in this street and some corner and next for some more time there, like that there are different pawn shops or coffee hotels, they will be sitting from morning to evening. So, from morning to evening they sit, they don't do any other thing. So, we also do the same thing, therefore it is tamoguna, we should not say that. It is not tamoguna. You see, it is a physical, in a physical way it appears to be tamas, but there is an intense activity going on. an activity of a superior type of activity, that a mental activity, so that vijnanam is taking place. So the mind is all the impurities of the mind, the junk of the mind is getting crushed away, and mind is getting exposed to some real knowledge. That is sattva. Sattva gunam is like a dirty mirror is taken, and some surf is added to that, and water is put, and the mirror is cleaned, and then dried. Then how it shines? So mind is made like that. The tamas and rajas are just cleansed, and the mind is now, it can reflect that consciousness in a very beautiful way. So that means when sarvam kalvidam brahma, when it is being presented, you will be able to appreciate it. So you can enjoy Vedanta, which is otherwise supposed to be very dry subject and all that. From morning to evening only Atmava, idam sarvam, like only one topic. So even if you listen to Vedanta for 12 years, the same topic will continue. So, but still you will be able to appreciate it more and more and more. That means that is the growth. Growth in terms of gunas, how? So rajas and tamas are reduced and sattva is increased. So when that kind of a growth takes place, you can visualize Brahma, sattvena pratilabhyaha. He can be visualized. So that is the meaning of sattva. Naishkarmyena. Naishkarmyena means it shows the negation of rajoguna. Na vidyate karma yasmin saha atma nishkarma. Atma is nishkarma. So, naishkarmya siddhim paramam. That word naishkarmya is used by Bhagavan in Gita. Same word is, very great word it is. So how that sequence is like this in Gita sequence, that explains the naishkarmya very well. You see, Bhagavan says, yatah pravurtir bhutanam yena sarvamidam tatam svakarmana tamabhyatsya siddhim vindati manavaha. So human being, he gains a siddhi by worshipping Ishvara. An Ishvara who is sitting somewhere, not that kind of Ishvara. An Ishvara from whom the entire universe has originated, and an Ishvara who is the antaryami of the entire Ishvara, the entire universe, who is sarvavyapaka, pervading the entire universe. Such an Ishvara who is in the form of this Jagat before us, in the form of the laws and the order and the niyati and the cosmos before us. So that Ishvara is worshipped. How you worship that in such an Ishvara? Not only by offering flowers, etc., but by performing our duties, so that nitya karma anushthanam karma yoga swakarmana tam abhyatya. So you do that, so you have an Ishvariya bhavana, you are able to visualize Ishvara in everything in this universe. At the same time you do your duty, to be done karma is done perfectly. So this is the definition of karma yoga. Over. So in one shloka the karma yoga is defined, swakarmana tam abhyatya. Up to that point karma yoga. So what is the result? Result is also in the same shloka. Siddhim vindati. Siddhi is obtained. Adhikari is also mentioned in the same shloka. Who is the adhikari? Manavaha. A human being is the adhikari. So siddhim vindati. The entire shastram has come in it. Siddhi is obtained. What is this siddhi? There is a siddhi in the next shlokam. It is called param siddhim. Therefore it must be apara siddhi. So, when we say graduate, undergraduate, then there must be a graduate, because this the person is called undergraduate. So this is siddhi. There is another siddhi, parasiddhi. So purvapara paryalochana, you have to analyze the things in a proper way. That is what is called vachya shastra. If you do the analysis, the meaning of siddhi comes out. That's why Bhashyakara has commented upon that word siddhi as jnana nishtha yogyata lakshanam siddhim. So you become eligible for jnana nishtha. That is the siddhi. It is a siddhi. Siddhi means a person walks on the water. It may be siddhi or not, we don't know. A person flies in the air. It may be another kind of siddhi. But here this siddhi is Gita variety of siddhi it is. It is not that kind of siddhi. This siddhi means jnana nishtha yogyata. So for you, Vedanta appears a bit meaningful, not totally boring. So fumes will be coming from the ears. By the time you listen to Vedanta for half an hour or 1 hour, fumes will be coming.
That means that jnananishtha yogyata is not yet taken place. That is the meaning of it. So, that you are able to appreciate Vedanta, enjoy it over a period of hours, that's a great achievement. So that yogyata is there. Jnananishtha yogyata. On this basis, the concept of naishkarmyam is built up. I will do tomorrow. Today this is too much of a thing. Tomorrow I will do naishkarmyam and go to the next shloka. So just one small question. What is your opinion about vastu? That is the question. I will answer it. And then I will leave you. You see, vastu is good. It's a good shastram. Like even astrology, vastu has got its own significance. And while constructing the house, you are advised to follow certain stipulations as per the vastu while constructing the house. For example, kitchen should be in the Ajneya. Agni is the Adhisthana Devata, presiding deity for that particular direction, one among eight directions. So Agni being the presiding deity, every direction has got a presiding deity. So Agni is the presiding deity for that particular direction. So better to have a kitchen there. Then there is another direction called Ishanya. Ishana is the presiding deity. Ishana is one name for Shiva. So that is the presiding deity. Hence, the altar, the puja graham, that should be in that direction. You should not have bathroom in that direction. So like that, these are some of the basic stipulations. It is enough if you follow them. It is not necessary to pull down the structures and re-erect the structures. All that is stretching the thing too far. So you need not do that. Finally, I tell you, even after one important principle of vastu is you should not encroach upon the neighbor's land. That is one interesting important principle in vastu. So I know people who follow vastu very scrupulously, while encroaching upon 1 yard this side and 1 yard that side. So what for you are following vastu? What is this? What a ridiculous situation. Our society has become like this. So they are very religious people committing blunders. Outright sins are committed. Yet they are supposed to be religious. So I don't know what kind of religion is this. It should not be, what kind of religious practice is this. Religion is okay, but religious practice should be meaningful. So vastu, first principle of vastu is never encroach upon.